Hello everyone, this is Gitanjali Shetty Call. I'm the founder of Secret Passages. I'm a circle facilitator. By circle facilitation, I mean holding space for conversations and dialogues to happen in the circle, where everyone has equal voice. And through circle facilitation, I bring about rhythm, that is breathing in and breathing out. So I bring 30% to the circle and 70% the group brings. So we create space for dialogues in the circle. So my Heart and Craft of Storytelling course, this is how storytelling workshop happens, where each one builds and brings their stories. While they do that, others are listening. When they share their narratives, when they share their experiences, others are only listening. So Secret Passages is a space where things and thoughts and speaking comes from inwards, comes from inside. And there is a feeling of being unmasked, vulnerability, of being accepted and heard. So it's a space which is non-judgmental and non-analyzing. What happens when the speaker starts talking in this kind of space? The speaker feels centered. He starts sharing from his or her center to the center of the circle. And that's how rhythm happens from inside out, slowly and slowly. We are able to see the root of our stories. We are able to see the growth of our stories. We are able to see the trigger and the transformation to what makes a good story. That's what Secret Passages does in its programs and its intervention. So here I am to share a story, or one of my favorite story, called The Rabbit Listened. It's by Corey. It's from this book. However, I'm not going to tell the whole story because I want all of you to buy this book. I'm going to give you a gist. This is the story of this boy, Taylor, who's just maybe 4 or 5 years old. And one day he wanted to build a tower. So he was very excited. He began planning. He began building the tower. He was very proud of himself. And suddenly the flight of birds came and crashed everything down. Taylor sat in the corner, feeling low. It was at this time that other animals came. First one to notice it was the chicken, and then the elephant, and then the other animals one by one. Everybody gave him different ways of fixing this. Everybody began analyzing. But there was this rabbit who came, sat next to Taylor, and his warmth, rabbit's warmth, made Taylor feel comfortable. He told rabbit to stay. And soon, Taylor began talking about how he was feeling. And soon, Taylor announces that he's all ready to build the tower again. That's what listening does. That's The Rabbit Listen. Buy this book, and this book is a must-have in every household, especially if you're a storyteller. My recommendation, The Rabbit Listen. Stay tuned for more stories and more ideas. Thank you.